Monsters don't cry in the dark. That's what I should have said to him when he looked over and told me that
he's a monster.
How do you define a monster? How would I define a monster?
That's a good question. What's a monster? Is anyone a monster? Should we give anyone that label?
A monster is the worst thing you can actually label a human being as.
It's terrible, it's horrifying, and I think it's something he carries with him from the moment they say it.
He's not who you think he is.
He looks the part to me.
You know, I grew up in LA in the 80s, and how often you'd hear stories about 12, 13, 14, 15-year-old kids who were hanging out with their older brothers who were Bloods or Crips, who ended up in the backseat of a car that was part of a drive-by shooting. And those minors were doing life. I mean, this is a story that's sort of been written and rewritten over and over again. There is a clear sense that there is a layer of institutional racism in this country. And I thought that today, more than ever, it was important for us to look at a character and the journey of a child like Steve through the lens that really lacked a black or white opinion, but had more of a very nuanced shade of gray, and letting the audience sort of stand back and form that opinion and be passionate about it.
Not this.
It's very easy for society to peel off the mask of humanity of a young black kid like Steve and label him as other than and as monstrous. One of the dynamics of the piece studies is this idea that for a 17-year-old kid, that one moment, one second, can define the totality of those 17 years. And can, from that point, define the totality of the life, really.
You're young, you're black, and you're on trial. What else do they need to know?
I thought it was innocent until proven guilty.
The movie puts things in perspective from so many different angles of so many different characters.
Manla articulates the message that the way you present yourself isn't always the way people perceive you.
We made very conscious decisions to archetype the story where, as a viewer, you could really stand on different sides of it and have completely different opinions.
You'll see that it goes much deeper than black and white.
Should I get an attorney?
You're gonna have to remain quiet.
Can I call my mom?
So many times, we're relying on our public officials, our district attorneys, our police officers, our judges, to look at these cases and apply some level of judgment to the case and not just be cut and dry about how the situation should play out.
A man told me once, the streets are your mother and the judge is your father. These kids are learning on the streets and then getting disciplined from these judges. So they really don't have a chance, a lot of them.
This is no monster. This is a 17-year-old boy. And the American justice system requires that when you look at Steve Harmon, you consider him innocent.
There is no nuance in the criminal justice system. You're either guilty or you're not guilty.
There is nothing more heinous than imprisoning a person who has not committed a crime.
We have to decide what kind of society we want to be. Do we want to continue to be the most incarcerated country in the world, or do we want to figure out a way to invest in our young people, give them the kind of opportunities they need, and help them succeed instead of putting them in the system for the rest of their lives?
I hope people have more sympathy and more of an understanding after watching this film as to why people in urban communities are under these circumstances, why the tension is like that, why people have preconceived thoughts, and why it's just, you know, all fucked up. It'll make sense. I think the story needs to be told because it happens all the time, you know?
There's been a lot of conversation in America about how we can be a more just society, how we can be a more free society, how we can treat every individual, no matter what their color or their income or their social status, we can treat everyone fairly and their interactions with the police and the criminal justice system can be fair. We want that for our society, but we're not there yet. And so I think it's important for us to have conversations about this. And I think art has a way of inspiring those conversations, breaking down barriers, and getting people to listen to each other.
What do you see when you look at me? Boy, artist, outsider, thug. Should one moment define my life?
Thanks for watching. Subscribe to the Netflix Film Club channel to get our latest exclusive videos. Plus, hit the bell so you don't miss a single one.